And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the Los Angeles Dodgers taking on the Houston Astros. First pitch coming at you right after the break.
Stay back, be patient, and hit the ball the other way.
And at the plate for the Dodgers, Shohei Ohtani. 1-1 down. Swing and a high fly ball down the left field line, but hooking foul. The pitch. Got him swinging. And one gone.
Very frustrating right there as a speedy potential base runner when with two strikes you just struggle to put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error, but some way you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
Here comes Freddie Freeman up to hit. Falling behind 2-1. The wind of the pitch. That ball one a little bit high. And now three balls and a strike. Out towards right center. That's well struck. That's back. And that one's gone. He flexes his power with that swing. And just like that, they're out front. It's 1-0.
Freddie has such a smooth swing. He makes these home runs look so effortless.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit. Spent on some other pitches in this at bat. Was very patient, and it paid off.
So one out, nobody on. Next up, the Dodgers catcher, Will Smith. Swing and a miss as he was late.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
This to third, and that should be extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. And he's in there. It's a first inning double.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Just found a way to slap that ball down the third baseline. That's really excellent bat control. And it kind of goes back to all those drills you see hitters do off the tee where it's placed in different spots. That was just nice.
Man at second with one away. Teoscar Hernandez steps to the plate for the Dodgers.
Two balls, one.
And another ball. One out and a runner at second, and we're just getting started here in the top of the first. Swing and a miss as he was out front.
So he's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Swings and misses, struck him out. And next for L.A., Andy Páez. And now the lefty the other way. And he boots it, headed for the plate. Throws to second. And he'll pull into second with two gone.
Well, that right there is a pretty clear example of why making a clean on-target throw back into the infield is so critical. But so many times it's easily overlooked. You can't be careless about it as an outfielder. Doesn't matter if you're throwing to a base or a cutoff, you have to give them something that they can handle. That cost him a run as a result.
At the plate, James Outman. Next offering is in for a strike. Man at second. That one down the line and foul ball. The pitch. In the dirt, blocked. To third, tag, got him. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. But two runs for him, and they jump ahead. Bottom half of inning number one coming up. It's the Dodgers 2, the Astros coming to bat. Back here at Minute Maid Park. And on the mound in this one, Gavin Stone.
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
Jose Altuve updated here. Obviously a guy who makes good contact, hits for average, but one of the things in today's game, the value in the fact that he hits both righties and lefties. Just missed. They're so reliant on the matchups nowadays, Chris, and it's huge when you don't have to sit a guy or platoon him.
When you can hit, you know, both sides in terms of pitcher's arms, you're a guy that it's hard to take out of the lineup, and I think it's very important.
Now we check out the Astros lineup. And the key to victory for them here, get their starter some run support early.
Boog, if they can get him that run support early, it's likely the other team folds because they know how dominant he can be once he gets settled in. So put pressure on that other team right away. Jump out to a lead early, and a few runs is going to feel like 30.
One out, base is empty. The wind and the pitch. And that one hammered. It's 2-1.
Well, there goes the shutout. Just like that, they're still behind, but this is a start. Velocity, it's so critical that you move the ball around, change speeds, even try to trick the hitter at times. But when you give up a home run right there, manager doesn't have a lot of patience because the velocity is not there to overcome and get the swing and miss.
One out, base is empty. Now it's Yordan Alvarez. One and two now. To the right side, Lux. And they get the out on Alvarez.
Good fade and sinking action of that changeup. Got that hitter to roll over.
Yainer Diaz.
Now, Yainer Diaz. Two outs, base is empty. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a drive, deep right field. That one's carrying, and it's gone. He sends it out of here. Second home run of the inning. And we're level. It's 2-2.
See a guy take a slider on the outside part of the plate and hit an opposite field home run, fires you up because not only is he flexing the muscles to show the power, that kind of approach, you'll hit for a high average as well.
So two down, and stepping in for the Astros, Jeremy Pena. Next pitch is downstairs.
Well, lots of pitches thrown in this first inning. It's kind of that nightmare scenario for starting pitching. But you know what? It's still early enough. He can settle in. He can get some length if he just cleans up his mechanics a little bit.
3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
It's been a little bit of a shaky inning, but he's still in a good spot to get out of this thing without giving up any more runs. He's just got to turn the page and go after this next guy.
And here is Jake Meyers. Check swing. Did he go? Yes, he did.
If it were an average catcher behind the plate, I'd say take second base. But this isn't a catcher you want to run on. His quick release is unreal.
Tied up here in the early going. Fights that one away. Still 1-2. And that's in the dirt.
Two strikes.
And the 2-2. Got him looking. And he did not like the call. But two round trippers in this inning, the long ball was working. And we're deadlocked now at 2 apiece. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Top of the second, and now the center fielder, James Outman.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
And that's off the inside edge. And a count 2-1. And another ball.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with the 3-1 count.
And that one is lifted in the air. Meyers snags it on the run. Miguel Rojas at the plate. Kicks and fires. That one pushed foul. One down, base is empty. Pitch in the dirt. The count now 2-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Couldn't catch up to the heater. Two outs, base is empty. And here is Gavin Lux. Next offering is in for a strike. That's outside. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. And that extends the inning.
Batting up. The third base.
Here's Kike Hernandez. The pitch. Swing and a miss.
This might be a steal situation, but that's not your average catcher behind the dish. You have to be careful here.
Lux off the first with two away.
He gave up a couple of runs in the first. His offense picked him up. It's time for him to settle in now.
Runner on the go. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Runner goes again. And they'll do it again. 2 gone, but the go-ahead run is at first. Here at the top of the second. Rudder goes again. Ball misses. Throw to second. Save. Chris's wheels were the difference maker on that play. Just got in there.
Yeah, with StatCast's help, we see his top speed on this stolen base, and that's a big number. I mean, man, he really made his athleticism work for him on that one.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Sometimes he wears the emotion on the sleeve, but that's okay as long as he's getting results. And right there, thrilled with the punch out to get out of a jam.
Bottom of the second. Leading now, up, here is Astros. Number 28.
The first baseman, number 28.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
That one to first. He'll do it himself. Oh. And quickly one away in the second.
No left field.
And stepping in, the rookie left fielder. Here's a 1-1. That one ripped. And that is a foul ball. The wind, the kick, and the 1-2. Good eye right there.
It's a good take.
Eric Summersgill with home plate duty of this one. Kind of known for being generous with the corners, Chris.
You know, I think that used to be a lot bigger deal in past eras where pitchers were working more in and out with their pitches. But, yeah, we'll see if those corners come into play in this one. Hey, no pitcher's going to argue at all.
Nabs it. Two down.
Boy, that was a hanging breaking ball right there. I think he tried to do a little bit too much. Sometimes those eyes can get really big. I think his swing broke down as well, and that's what caused him to pop it up.
So two down now, and here is Trey Cabbage. Missed with a changeup, 2-1. In the air, left field. Drifts towards it. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. We move ahead to the third. Tied 2-2. Back here in Houston. Now it's the DH, Shohei Ohtani. The 1-1.
One ball, two strikes.
Two and balls, another ball. Swing and a miss. Gassed it right by him.
Great location with that two-strike fastball. I'll tell you what, as a hitter, you're looking to protect the outside part of the plate, stay back on something off speed. So many times, that location with two strikes, you just can't get around on it, and that's a tough one to compete with.
Freddie Freeman up to the dish. Though Chris, through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. Two-two now. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. One down, base is empty. Out to short. And that quickly, two away.
Well, he didn't recognize changeup earlier enough. Got out in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and beat it into the ground.
And up to the plate is Will Smith. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now. Doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. That one ripped, but foul. Two down, nobody on. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Wasting no time. He's two for two now on the night. And just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. Two outs, runner at first. Here's Teoscar Hernandez. Ball and a strike. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. Smith leads off first with two down to the inning. That's a little bit low. Bounced up the middle. The underhand flip. They get the force. That's out number three. One left for LA. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. Back here in Houston. Now it's the second baseman, Jose Altuve.
Altuve always seems to be setting records or reaching milestones, Boog. In 2023, he became the fastest player to reach 2,000 career hits, 200 home runs, and 200 stolen bases in MLB history.
One and two now. Altuve waits. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Another 1-2. Grips one to right. That's a base hit. Made a board on the leadoff single.
He was all over that one. Textbook bat control right there. Got a pitch on the outside. Saw it deep into the zone and just barreled it up. Went the other way for the knock.
Here's Alex Bregman. Pitch. Altuve runs on the ground. Sends it across the first, and they get Bregman for the out.
That's a good piece of hitting right there. The job was to move the runner up and give your team a chance to score the go-ahead run. That's exactly what happened, so you better believe your teammates are happy with you after that at bat.
Swing, he went too far, and it's a strike.
One ball, two strikes.
And a swing and a miss. And there are two down. Next to hit, Yainer Diaz.
The catcher, Yainer Diaz.
Next offering in there for a strike. One and two.
Then he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Three. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. That's the third out. One left for Houston. Score remains 2-2. And we're back. John Ciampi with Chris Singleton. And set to lead off the fourth, Andy Pajes. Here's a rocket out to left. Makes the catch for the out. One down.
Now
here is James Outman. we talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. All tied up, top half of inning number four. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive, because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit, or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
The bat after the left.
Miguel Rojas steps to the plate for the Dodgers.
This is a great dynamic right here. Speedy runner at first, thinking about taking second. Catcher with the pop time that leaves jaws on the floor. This might get interesting, dude.
Base knock, center field. Just kind of slice that one into center. Close play, but in there.
I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Runners on the corners with one gone. And now it's Gavin Lux. Next offering is down low.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
On the ground, a short could be two. Off balance feed, there's one. Not in time at first. It's a fielder's choice.
I promise you, they're guys that get a little bit faster when they can smell an RBI. That was a possible inning-ending double play. Great hustle, and he gets rewarded with the RBI because of it.
Here's Kike Hernandez. And another ball. Lux off of first with two away. Two outs. Just misses the mark outside the zone. Shohei Ohtani waiting to bat for the Dodgers. And there's ball four.
Oh, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question. I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Here comes a pitch. Ground ball right side. And that's just foul. One, two now. And it skips in the dirt. Activity in the bullpen for Houston. Josh Hader, the left-hander, up and throwing. Into center on his way over. He's got it, and that'll do it. Two men left stranded, but they do push across one. We're midway in the fourth. It's the Dodgers 3 and the Astros 2. And welcome back to the ballpark. Bottom four, and stepping in for the Astros, Jeremy Peña. And that just misses.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Yeah. Hawaii to kick the pitch. Got him. Looks like he's picked up right where he left off. And next to hit now for Houston, Jake Myers. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. And a base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
And now the first baseman. And a pitch. Fouls it off, still one and two.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Left-hand batter waits. On the ground a second, might be two. There's one. On to Freddie. Double play.
Well, the second baseman made that one look easy. Great feed to the shortstop. Shortstop completes the play. They get out of a jam, and they end the inning.
So Josh Hader gets the call to the mound.
Well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
And here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is I want to stay square to the plate, to try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
Check swing, no appeal.
Almost got him to commit, but he held back.
And a pitch. Swings through that one.
They really need to hang in there with that front side against this left-handed breaking ball.
At the belt and fires. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. The pitch. 3-2 now.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Now fly ball to right center. Cabbage under it. Puts it away for the out.
The catcher, Will.
The batter now will be Will Smith. Base is empty, one away, and we're at the top of the fifth. Slice down the right side. The 1-2. And that's down and away.
Two balls, two strikes.
That one misses. Ball three. And a pitch. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And two away now.
Oh, there he gets the slider in on his hands, and it just eats him up. You know, it's hard to get the bat around on a pitch like that in tight. You just feel like you're crowded on the inside part of the plate. Can't get any extension. That's one he definitely should have laid off of.
Good eye in that spot. 2-2 now. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Nothing doing for the Dodgers here, but they're up 3-2. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And stepping in for the Astros, number 10.
On the mound, he had a little trouble back in the first, but it's been a different story the rest of the way. Really settled into this outing nicely.
And that one fouled off.
So glad these ballparks have installed the netting to protect the fans, keep things safer all around the league.
Kicks and deals. And it's even up. Wouldn't chase that time. Trey Cabbage up next for the Astros. Payoff pitch. Foul off again. And it remains 3-2. And a pitch. High fly ball out into left center field. Hernandez ranging after it. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down.
The right field.
So up next, Trey Cabbage. That one in the dirt. Ball two. Next offering is outside.
He missed the zone, but I don't think he missed his spot. That was a good pitch with two strikes.
Home team down a run. Last half of inning number five. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Good job to fight that one off. One down, base is empty. On the ground, right side, and it goes just foul. The kick, the 3-2. And down on strikes he goes. He didn't make it easy for him on the mound, but they still get the strikeout.
Well, definitely a borderline pitch right there, and he didn't look too convinced as he headed back to the dugout. No, those are tough ones to let go as a hitter, but with the human umpire calling balls and strikes, it's always going to be on you to protect yourself with two strikes.
Here's the former MVP, Jose Altuve. Ground ball, Freddie Freeman. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. No runs, no hits, no errors. We're through five. It's the Dodgers 3 and the Astros 2. Top six, digging in, Andy Páez.
Leading off from Los Angeles, the right fielder, number 44, Andy Páez.
The pitch. Swings through that one, it's a strikeout. So digging in, James Outman. So now the hard-throwing left-hander Josh Hader on the hill. And when you look at the start of Hader's career, pretty incredible. Arguably one of the top beginnings to a career for any reliever in history. The Astros have some action in their pen. Rafael Montero up and loosening in the pen. Number 74, the lefty, warming up as well. And here comes. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Two gone.
And he'll be beating himself up on the way back to the dugout. Got a pitch to hit and just couldn't get to it. I think that slider really caught way more of the plate than it was supposed to.
Here's the shortstop at the plate. Miguel Rojas. Hader at times can have some trouble with command, but it's that fastball slider combo that is so impressive. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
All sliders so far in this at bat to get ahead in the count, and clearly shows there was a game plan in mind for how to attack him in the box.
Next pitch misses. Now 2-2. Two down, nobody on. And we're the top half of the sixth. That one misses, and it's 3-2. Line drive. And foul ball. Swing and a ball lifted to center field. Myers makes the catch, and that'll do it. Offense held in check there. 2-3-4, two up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Dodgers 3 and the Astros 2. New pitcher coming on, the veteran, Daniel Hudson.
Still a lot of game left, and this game could go either way. So this is a big opportunity for him to get some important outs and try to help carry this lead into the later innings.
Now it's Alex Bregman. He had a big swing for these guys way back in the first inning.
Yeah, Boogie didn't waste any time in this one. The solo shot really got his team going, and he's looking for more right here.
Kicks and fires. And a swing and a miss.
Well, a come and get me fastball right there. He didn't look ready for the velocity. I think it'd be a mistake to throw him anything off speed right here.
One and two here. Swings and misses. Struck him out. Slider got him for strike three.
Well, we see it a lot more these days than we ever did when I played, but a slider in the 90s still catches your attention. Even if you're sitting on the pitch, good luck recognizing that tight spin and adjusting to the late break.
Here's Jordan Alvarez. One down, base is empty. That's way outside, and that's ball two. Hit out of the center field. So they get a man aboard with a one out single.
The bat. The catch.
Yiner Diaz up next for the Astros. With the go ahead run at the plate here in the bottom of the sixth. Next pitch is outside. Activity in the bullpen for the Dodgers. Johan Ramirez up and throwing. Got him! Now two out.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
Jeremy Pena up next for the Astros. And a 1-1. In the air, out towards left center. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that is that. So the Astros leave one. They're down 3-2. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, number 74.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
So digging in, Gavin Lux.
The second baseman, Gavin Lux.
Swung on, popped up on the infield. Gets under it. And there's one away.
The third baseman, number 8, Kike.
Here's the third baseman, Enrique Hernandez. That one fouled off, 2-2. One down, base is empty. In the air, center field. Myers under it. And there's two away.
Now
back. Shohei Ohtani up to the dish.
Well, he's always a threat. Even if this guy is 0 for 3 for the night with 3 strikeouts, he can come up that fourth time and do damage because he's that good.
Just missed. Two down, nobody on. Here in the top half of inning number 7. That one misses. Now 3-1. Freddie Freeman up next for the Dodgers. Two down, nobody on. That's in there. And the count's full.
The count is full.
Outside, and that is ball 4.
One of the things about that 2-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a 2-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
Runner on the goal. Pitch misses in. Throw to second. Great jump. And that is a stolen base. It wasn't even close.
Well, it really doesn't matter what the situation is. When a guy like this gets on first, you know he's going to steal second at some point during the at-bat. Nice job to get in the scoring position. The defense probably knew it was coming, but they just couldn't do anything to stop it.
The count 2-1.
Two balls, two strikes.
Just off the outside part of the plate. Will Smith waiting to bat for the Dodgers. Man on second, two down. So now two on and two outs.
Now bat.
And at the plate for the Dodgers, Will Smith. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. Hard ground ball, base knock. Rounds third, headed for the plate. Here comes the throw. It's off the mark, and he scores.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch run scoring at bat.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. First and second, two outs. And now Teoscar Hernandez. Swing and a miss. And a count, 1-2.
1-2.
Across a run. It's now 4-2. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Anthony Bonda.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect the tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
Jake Myers getting ready to hit.
The center fielder.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
And now the lefty.
Two-two now.
That one just misses. Goes down swinging for the strikeout. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. A big first out here in the seventh via the punch out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you got the leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
And now the first baseman. The Dodgers trying to protect a two-run lead here at the bottom of the seventh. And that's outside. Fly ball down the line. Pajas makes the play, and there's two away.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Now the left fielder. Two outs. Popped up left side. Rojas settles under this one. Makes the grab. And that is the third out of the inning. Astros are down quietly. They trail it here 4-2. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Rafael Montero.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
And now the right fielder, Andy Pajas.
The right fielder, number 44, Andy Pajas.
The 1-1. Swings through that.
One ball, two strikes.
Foul ball still, 1-2 count. And the righty deals. Fights that one away, still 1-2. City blasted it right past him.
Well, you got to be pretty quick with the bat speed these days. So many guys throwing in the upper 90s, and you see the velocity on that one, just tough to catch up to. I mean, guys are coming in and they're going max effort. They're not looking to go a long distance. They want to get as many strikeouts as they possibly can.
Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. Action in the pen down there. Caleb Ort getting ready to go. Martinez also throwing. Base is empty, one away, and we're at the top of the eighth. Swing and a miss, struck him out, and there's two down.
Very strong coming out of the pen so far as he punches out the first two batters he's faced in this one, getting straight to work. Man, it's talked about a lot, but relievers are just so electric these days. These aren't fun at bats if you're a hitter. I'm so glad I'm retired.
That one missed. And a swing and a miss.
Two balls, two strikes.
And down on strikes. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Dodgers go down quietly, but they still lead this one 4-2. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth. Blake Treinen. He has a great slider with tons of movement. So digging in, Trey Cabbage.
The right fielder.
And the right-hander deals. Next offering misses down and away. And he grounds one to the right side. Lux on to first. One gone to the bottom of the eighth.
Good slider inside right there. Batter fighting to get there. Just rolled over it. Got the ground ball.
So next, Jose Altuve. One down, base is empty. Off the mark there. And a count 2-1.
Pretty easy to give up on that pitch right there. Started on the edge of the plate with the spin. You know it's going to finish well off the plate.
Swings and misses. And it's 2-2. The Astros down by a pair near the bottom half of the eighth inning. Got him looking for the strikeout. Couldn't pull the trigger on a fastball at the knees. And now it's third Alex Bregman.
Alex Bregman.
And he deals. Gets him to chase after that one.
One ball.
Looking very settled on the mound here in the eighth. One more out, and they'll probably hand it off to their closer for the ninth with at least a 2-run lead.
Right side, hard hit. Throw on to Freeman, and they get Bregman for the out. Three up, three down, inning over. Nothing doing there for Houston. Still down by a count of 4-2. Back here in Houston, all set for the start of the inning. Here's the second baseman, Gavin Lux. Left-hand hitter waits. Foul ball. On its way to the corner, and no one could get to it. It's a foul ball. Righty to the plate. And downstairs.
Two balls, two strikes.
Just missed. Here comes a 3-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The pitch. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. Time, but it finishes with a strikeout. You can't be mad at yourself after an at bat like that one. Kike Hernandez will hit next. Base is empty, one away here at the top of the ninth. Swings and misses at the pitch off the plate.
Well, there's a certain point where you have to commit to what you think you see, and he guessed wrong right there. Nasty slider with just terrific bite at the end.
Just misses, and it's 2-2.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. With that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
A wind and a pitch. stays alive. The pitch. Fights it off. He'll see another.
In cruise control, autopilot, just dominating these hitters. It doesn't look like it's a fun at bat. And all of a sudden, you become in awe of this guy on the mound. Somebody's got to break this thing up. That's five straight strikeouts. Got to put a ball in play.
Here's Shohei Ohtani. Two down, nobody on. That misses the zone. Now two balls and a strike. The wind of the pitch. Popped in the air. Left field. Settles underneath it. Squeezes it. And that is that. So the Dodgers have a new arm on the mound. Evan Phillips.
Well, he's the guy they hope to turn to out of the pen to lock down wins. So this game has gone to plan, more or less. Let's see if he can wrap it up here.
3-4-5 due up for the home team. Yordan Alvarez now at the plate.
Alvarez.
And that's in the dirt. Two balls, two strikes.
Looking to get something going. This is the guy you want at the plate. He's been great for this team. He is a professional hitter.
This one in the air, right field. Páez under this one. Makes the grab, one away.
The bat. The catcher.
He's two outs away. Here's the catcher, Gainer Diaz. The Stros trailing by two. They're the last half of inning number nine. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. One down, base is empty. Ground ball left side, and that's just foul. And a 1-2. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Astros down to their last out. So next up for Houston, Jeremy Pena. Two-run game, a two away here in the bottom of the ninth. On a line out towards center. He dives but can't hang on. That's a base hit. The tag, and that's the ball game.
Well, this was a total team effort using six pitchers in this ballgame to get the win. Outstanding job of passing the baton, the next pitcher stepping up and getting it done. You got to give them a lot of credit because this is not easy to do. We'll see how it affects them over the next couple of days.
And your final 4-2. Dave Roberts and company celebrate in the dugout. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long. Thank you.
here now is our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Dodgers. Four runs, seven hits, no errors. They left seven runners on base.